A popular idea that has been making the rounds on the internet of late is that egg whites make a good burn treatment. You may have found yourself wondering if this is actually true. Well, the short answer is no. Egg whites do not help with burns, and they can actually make the situation a whole lot worse. On the surface, this idea does seem actually quite plausible. The egg whites are made mostly of water, 90%, and numerous proteins, 10%, like albumin and globulins. Cooling with water is a well-known and time-tested treatment for pain relief associated with minor burns. Most egg whites tend to be cooler than the area being burned, so that only leaves us with the proteins to consider. So now, let's look at burns and what we're trying to treat, and see if the added proteins to the water are more helpful than the plain water itself. There are several types of burns, including chemical, electrical, friction, radiation, and thermal, both hot and cold. No matter the cause of the burn, the results can leave the skin and underlying tissue extremely damaged. When it comes to the severity of the burn, they are separated into three main classes, denoting the depth of the burn. First-degree burns often only involve the outer layer of the skin, the epidermis. Second-degree burns involve both the epidermis and the layer underneath, the dermis. Third-degree burns often involve the epidermis, dermis, and the muscle tissues underneath. Some medical professionals have advocated for a fourth degree of burn that denotes when the person's bones are also burned. However, this is something that hasn't really seemed to get much traction. The focus on treating burns revolves around four main things: stopping the burning, pain relief, infection control, and warding off dehydration and hypothermia. The skin is a fantastic organ that's responsible for protecting our bodies from outside pathogens like bacteria and viruses. It also helps keep our precious body fluids in place and gives us a nice bone blanket to keep warm. When the skin gets damaged, it can no longer provide us with those benefits. It's no surprise then that infection, dehydration, and hypothermia are the most common lethal complications of burns. For instance, infection is the leading cause of death in burn victims, accounting for approximately 10,000 deaths per year in the United States alone. Now that we know what we're trying to treat, let's see if egg whites help with each of the four methods of treatment. For starters, stopping the burning. When it comes to chemical burns, egg whites definitely will not help. To stop that burning, you need to brush the chemical off and then flush the area with copious amounts of water to get any microscopic material off that's left. Obviously, egg whites will do nothing to stop electrical, thermal, or friction burns either, unless of course you have something like a bathtub filled with egg whites for the burning person to jump into, but that just seems a bit far-fetched. In the end, egg whites won't stop the burning process. Now, that one, yeah, it's somewhat obvious. So what about pain relief? Third-degree burns have damaged the nerve cells so badly that the areas affected by these types of burns, they don't actually hurt. So we're just going to focus on first and secondary burns. The only study we were able to find that looked at treating burns with both water and egg whites was done in Milas in Turkey. The results of that study showed that subjects treated with egg whites had no greater decrease in pain compared to those who used only water. While many substances that are cool and cover a burn area will provide some pain relief, numerous studies have shown the use of most home burn remedies to treat burns greatly increases your chance of complications compared to those using only water. In the end, even though you might get some initial pain relief from applying cold egg whites on minor burns, water does the same thing without all the complications, which we're going to talk about shortly. Next up, infection control. Infections are the leading complication associated with burns. Because of this, they're arguably the most important thing to consider when treating someone who has been burned. The proteins in egg whites do nothing to help with infection. In fact, they will most likely increase the chance of infection, as eggshells, yolks, and whites can all contain numerous types of bacteria, including salmonella. So if you thought egg whites might help with infection, well, they actually do the opposite. So this brings us to dehydration and hypothermia. Dehydration is a big concern for those treating burns, as a person whose skin has been damaged will be leaking fluid from their bodies. This fluid is not leaking from a victim's vascular system, but rather from the areas around your cells, organs, and blood vessels known as your interstitial space. Once that fluid begins to be lost, you will start to draw fluid from within your cells, organs, and blood vessels, further complicating the dehydration. This is such a concern due to the amount of fluid burn patients lose that there is now a standard formula for how much you need to give them. This is known as the Parkland Formula. This formula goes that you take the patient's weight in kilograms, you multiply it by 4, and then by the percentage of the body surface area burned. Half of that volume will need to be given in the first 8 hours, and the other half in the next 16 hours. As an example, let's look at an example of a person who's 180 pounds, that's 82 kilograms, and let's say that they have 50% of their body area burnt. They will need 8.2 liters of water in the first 8 hours and the same again in the next 16. For reference, that same person only has about 5.4 liters of blood volume. Egg whites, certainly not going to help with rehydrating someone, and since we've already discussed that it's a cooling substance, it's not going to help them with hypothermia either. Alright, so the last vestige of this myth is one where some people say it helps with skin regeneration. The problem with this thought process is how skin actually repairs itself. In order to make this episode not too much longer and not too repetitive, if you're interested in a more full explanation on how skin repairs itself, you can watch our video on how scars form. But the short version is that the proteins that are involved with skin regeneration don't begin weaving their magic, they form a basket weave appearance, until after a scab is formed. The scab will certainly prevent any egg proteins from assisting in regeneration. If it didn't, bacteria would be able to enter and we would be back to that whole infection problem. So there you have it. Egg whites will not play a positive role in helping treat burns, particularly not over something like water. Though, of course, that'd be better than something like, say, treating a burn with battery acid. But over simple water, the egg whites, they will just make things worse. Now, if you are interested in a home remedy that actually works and has several positive benefits on burns, after thoroughly rinsing the area with clean water, apply a generous amount of raw honey. And that is going to be the subject of an upcoming video, so stay tuned. And I say stay tuned, but what I really mean is subscribe and hit that notification bell and that like button. It all helps out. And if you're looking for something else to watch right now, check out some of the videos I linked to on the screen. And as always, thank you for watching.